What's up, Pillow? What's up? Working on the artwork for the new boss some more today. This is kind of fun, just getting into the zone with pixel art. It's always fun to switch into this mode. It's kind of a non-technical creative task that is so satisfying in a way. Love it. So I've settled on something for this guy's boomerang attack. I'm using basically he throws his like a ghost sword, but it's like a boomerang sword. So it looks something like this. This is a rough version of this artwork. Then the first step I wanted to, let me show you what that looks like in the game, actually. Let's get to the right frames rate though, so they don't kill the CPU while I'm streaming. I mean, recording this video. Okay, so let's take a look at that. See how much pixel art can get done in this video. There it is. It's a little too bright. Needs to be the right color. But I'm liking it. It's a lot better than what it was before. So let's keep playing with that art. Let's change its color first of all. Somehow this is like already the right hue. Oh, maybe because I have this color. Let's get that super saturated. It's looking pretty good. Let's render that. Charge attack. I remember the something like that hue. That's 346. Oh, and it's a little too opaque. It'd be nice if it were just slightly transparent. Just modify. Does that work for all of them? Wow, that's nice. Let's do 70% opaque. Which is just kind of ridiculous that I'm doing this in the artwork when this can be done with data. Or it could just be additive. Let's see what it looks like additive. Nah, I'll try opacity first. With that. No, this does not have a shadow. There. I've been cleaning up his animations. Might just be the east one though. Man, I spent a lot of time on this boss so far. It's a tough one to get right. I think I've spent more time on this one than Metatron. Plus this whole friggin' arena here. Hope all y'all players are thankful. Goddamn. What the heck does the charge doubles? What animation does that use? Melee? Oh, we just need the melee. Hooked up in Rens. Which one's it missing? Oh, I just forgot to export the north one, huh? Okay, so we need those. Can't get rid of those. Just kind of heading off on tangents here, but thank you. Okay, I'll start to refine this boomerang sword art. See how that looks. Capacity this now.
Some kind of like throw and catch animation where it really works.
find it later. So let's we can keep it open. Okay. Let's check it in. Okay, to start with from the beginning, his intro animation does this sort of weird pixel art thing, but it doesn't really work for the concept of Ren. Ren has the power of zero. He's got the meditative power, the bioenergy, and that way, Zero has his, when Zero warps, he uses his bioenergy instead of like technology. So that's why he looks all weird and like he's underwater. So I'm gonna do the same kind of effect for when this guy, when Ren blinks, look like he's underwater sort of. Plus, I want him to appear a taller in general. So this, when he starts, I'm gonna have him go into this stance. Well, speaking of this stance, he's got a little bit too much of a shoulder shrug going on. Let's see what it looks like with his head slightly turned like that. Oh, that thing has hit points. So I get warps in. I'm gonna warp into that tall stance. Okay, just to be the other. Let's try a little something else here. This one too. Just one of these frames, let's make it just super poppy. Experiment with that. that it feels like it should be this frame. It should be all these, or like maybe this should be like that's cool. That it's actually looking pretty good. Let's get him to go from his tall stance into that stance, and also getting him so his, yeah, he's got, I really want this arm in the same kind of position as his sword too while he's in the tall stance. good to focus on the little simple pieces of artwork, especially when you start to feel stuck. Like I was really feeling stuck on this earlier today. And now I really just got the flow, and it's really helping to just focus on the super simple animation and the one little thing that I desire for which is just to get it in a little bit taller looking. You know, it's like, just make him look a little taller, a little more composed, a little more calm. Frame or two going from here to the charged animation. Whoa. Uncharge is the third though. Yeah, he's got that animation. All right. And he's got delay 0.2 though. That's correct. Cool, that's a good win. I like that. Okay, I'm gonna take a quick little break here. Okay, back to this intro. All right, so he's going to end up here. About 10 frames of difference here, which means I can take this effect about 10% each time. So going into using this wavy effect, let's see how it would look at 100% first. I'm not sure if that's enough. use a little technique that I used on zero, which was to flip every other one of these frames. I flip, then do the distortion, then flip again. Isn't that the same? Wait, hold on. No, not quite. Still looks mega weird though. I just, what?
Hope this looks good.
Just took a minute. It does kind of give it that ripply feeling. Let's see how it looks. Yeah, I don't know. It just didn't look that cool with the whole flipped thing going on. I'm gonna redo all these flip frames, try them without the flip. Doesn't it look any different? This is why I did the flip in the first place. With Zero's original art, it just didn't. Maybe I could try small instead of medium or something. That's not working either. Maybe I should alternate going like way less or something. We were 400. Now let's try like this one's gonna be 320. So let's try this one like just 240. Yeah, that might work. This one's 320. This one's 160. This one's 200. This one's 80. Maybe this one will be like 20. Better. Missing his old animation for blinking. There's something good about that one. Okay, and what if the intro also had the old... Just kind of like layered on top of each other. Give it like a halfway wavy, halfway pixely look. This could work. Let's give him a mode where he forcibly goes into a charged attack. So when he first shows up, he always has a charge attack right away. I think that'll look better. Intro as the blink. One frame at the beginning where he's completely invisible, I think. Oh yeah, anyway, I guess we would reverse it the other way around too. And the blink. The blink had 15. Intro has 11. That's a little bit more, 0.054. Ugh. Let's try. We'll do like a throw catch. Use that for the freeze. Okay, I'm quite happy with this actually. These are good results to be getting here. I'm not using that. Okay, I think that's cleaned up. Just make sure you can run it one last time, and you should still work. Shouldn't crash. It'll crash if it was missing any art from what I just did there, with that cleanup. And then I can check this in, and that'll be it for this stream video. That's what I said. That's what I meant. Last thing, let's clean this up right. Let's make this, instead of calling this blink, this is no longer blink, this is throw. doesn't need these last frames anymore, which means it's going to go from 11 frames long to 7 frames long. Let's render that. Just make sure the timing's right. So we went from, more time per frame. So 11 divided by 7 times whatever. Crazy. Throw catch. This times 0.4. Okay, let's make sure that still the right timing. Probably not going to be flipped on the X plane correctly, or the flipped on the whatever the Y plane, X plane. Shoot, I don't know. Running out of energy. What? Oh, maybe I took away that one thing that makes it crash. So there's no rend blink anymore. Okay. Oh yeah, that's when I added that whole multiple skin thing. Okay.
Customized.
thanks for watching this video. Appreciate your support. Appreciate all your support, all you viewers and players and stuff. This has been a really crazy cool 3 years of life building this video game, and I'm excited to make it even better. So cheers, thanks for watching. I'll hit you up on the next video.